Good afternoon, everybody. In this video, I want to show you some things for my show file I've been using on the MA2 the last few years. I put a link to the show file in the description, so if you want to have a look at it yourself, take a look. If you want to use some things, you're free to do so. Just buy me a beer when you find something useful. Two things before I start. I'm using this show file on my own on-PC setup. So I've got a command wing and a fader wing and a big touchscreen in front of me. So that's why I'm using external screen 2 for most of the time. If you're trying to follow this video, it could be helpful to watch it on a bigger monitor. Second thing is that I'm using the show file for club shows and festival shows for bands. So that's why that's what I'm using it for most of the time. So just to let you know, I already did some preparations. So I already patched some fixes and patched some spots, some washes, and some LED lights. As you see in my patch, I use some standard numbering. So I use my spots always start at 1, my washes always start at 51. And the LEDs always start at 201. And that's easy for myself, but also I've got some macros who are using these numbers to select the fixtures and to do some programming. I also already made some odd and even groups for spots, wash and LEDs. And I also made a layout with all the fixtures in it. When I start a show, I have some macros to prepare some things for me. There are different ways to adjust your show file to a different venue, a different festival, but this is the one that worked for me. I've got a macro to create some standard groups. So now I have my standard spot, wash and LED groups, and all the other things aren't recorded because what does it do? I could also make some groups for beams and for side lighting and for miscellaneous, but it only does that when it sees these fixtures in patch. For example, my beam spots start at 101, and if I have some beam spots patched, then it does these things. It stores the groups, stores some worlds, and labels the world and the groups. But because I didn't patch any beam spots, all these comments aren't executed. And that's why this group isn't made and this world isn't made. So that keeps it clean, that you don't have a lot of empty groups down here. It also made some worlds, so spot, wash, and LED, and labels these worlds. So that's what this macro does for me. Got some colors as well, so to create some standard colors. And just the standard colors like the whites, add some standard values, and of course you still have to tweak these for the different lights, but it gives me a good start. Create some gobos and zooms, also some standard palettes, and create some standard positions. And it doesn't really make sense because the desk doesn't know what kind of positions work, but at least now I have some positions with some standard labels that I can use later on for my show. Okay, these are my standard things to start with. Next step for me is to build some standard playbacks. And I'll first let you see what happens, and then I'll explain a bit about how this works. So I've got executors 1 and executors 2. These are the same, except that they use different rate masters and speed masters. So exec 1 for my spots, and select a fader. And what this macro does is it creates this fader with just intensity in it, and also a queue with some effects. It creates these. This is odd even for intensity, this is odd even for bumps, And this one part form and BIM things. And it also creates fader and executor for one part for intensity on the next page. I can also make this for the other weight masters, executes two in my show file for the washers, and put this beside these. And the funny thing is that I just have to select one executor and all the other executors are placed underneath. So if I select executor two, then 102 is the same groups, but with odd even, then 17 is something, 112 is my one part bump. And on the next page, I have a fader two, executor two, that's the one part dimmer for the same group. So that's a bit what this macro does. And it uses a Lua plugin to make this happen. And what does Lua does in this case? It uses the label of this group. So it uses label wash. It uses these groups, wash odd and wash even, to create the executors. And it also uses a little plugin to see what executor I selected and to split that in a page. So in this case, page 8. So I can record something new on page 9, and also it splits the selected executor in, for this example, executor 2. So I can use it to record 102, 107, and 112 with the same groups. So it's a bit of Lua and a bit of macro to make that executor. And I can also do that for my LEDs. So executors 2, and you see here as well that I'm not selecting the group, but I do a change destination. And when I do that for the group, I use a bit of Lua to get the label out of it. And the next step is select. So select executor, and it also makes these other executors as well. And let me see if these work. So I now have for the spots, this is the effect, and it's just a simple three-part effect. The top, have these on. I can also lower the intensity of the spots. And a funny thing is, because I did a little trick with a few cues and a few comments behind it. If I select these, let me see what happens. And I lower this value. So if I give this a go, then I've got a one part and going intensity to full and going back. And that's just triggering the executor on the second page. So you can see it happen here. If I give the executor on page 8 a go, it triggers the executor on page 9. So just a little bit trick. So now I have one executor. I can put my spots on, 60% for example. And I give it a go, it bumps it to 100 and falls back again to the level I set with this fader. So just a bit of trick with these cues and with the comment in that cue. So I have one executor triggering multiple things. Now if I select dot even down here, just this, and I don't know if the bumps work already. Let's have a look. So even these work. So there's a two-part bump on this one and a one-part bump on executor 111 at this moment. What else do I have for the macros? I have some things I don't use that often for three parts as well, but let me do some things with the colors. And I have to switch back to the full world. So I have color row 1, and I'll show you what it does. Color row 2 for the washers, and color row 3 for the LEDs. And what does it do? It makes playbacks on this action button page for the spots, for the washes, and for the LEDs, And it also takes the label from the group I created. So it takes the label spots, the washes, and the LEDs. This isn't really a funky layout view, like you see most of the time nowadays. I just never took the time for it. Maybe in these times I will create a layout view, but this worked for me. And here I can choose the spots, the washes, and the LEDs. And I have some macros down here, so I can trigger the colors for the different groups in one time. Here at the end, are some macros to change the fade time. So this is for all the colors. And I also can change the fade time for each row. What else do you have? These are for the colors. So can live kind of a busking page for the colors. I also have these for the spots, the wash and the floor position, but these don't work at the moment because I didn't program any positions. I do have them for zooms, for the robots. So if I look at the buttons right now, I have some executors for the spots and the washes for my zoom, for so small, medium and large I can use. And also has some gobos. I don't use that much gobos, so that's why you just see three gobos over here and an open. Now, well, maybe it's a good time to show some positions. How do these work? I've got a little macro over here, so I have one button for the palettes I'm using, so for the colors and for the focus position, etc. And if I press it two times, I'm directed to the view with the positions, and I'll program some positions for the spots. So, for example, this is a good one for my straight. Tilt 30 and 1.0. This is a good one for the blinds. And creating some position for the wash as well. So tilt 60, store for the roof. So I've got two positions for the spots, straight and blind, and one for the roof for my washes. And if I'm triggering my macros for spots and the wash positions, I also get some executors for the spots and the washes, but it only programs them for the positions I've made. So I've made straight and the blind for the spots, and I made the roof for the washes, and it's only executors that are created at this moment. And there's just a little trick in it. So what it does, I put it in plugin, and there are some if criteria in it. So if the group is in the position, then it creates the executor, and otherwise it doesn't. And that's all in this little Lua plugin over here. You could also do that with macro, but I also using this plugin to take the name out of the groups. So that's why I made this. So that's this little bit. The spot position, wash position. What else do I have? I have some macros to invert my pen and invert my tilt. So I can select some fixtures and do pen invert in the patch, and then, for example, tilt invert in patch, and also offset. It's way easier than going to your patch and to change offset and the inverts over there, because it saves a lot of time. And it's not that complicated. What it does is the selected fixtures are stored in the world, and all these fixtures in the world are assigned a pen demix invert, or a pen demix invert off, or a tilt invert. It's a bit quicker than going to the patch and change over there. Real time saver when you don't have that much time. Also for the encoder inverts, you can also do that with these buttons, but I don't use that a lot. It's these first ones, pen invert, on and off, tilt invert, on and off, and offset. These are the most important ones for me. So, what else do I have to show you at the moment? Because I want to do my effect things a bit later. I think I've done the most important things right now. Okay, so that's a bit of a start. I showed you how I use the exec macros to make some standard playbacks for me, so standard executors. I also have one for my conventional lights that don't have a bump executor. So for example, I have two groups, ACL and blind over here. If I want to make the same thing, so I have dim for my ACLs and for this, then it creates an executor. And the same thing as the other one. So I've got an, look, do I have a channel somewhere? So it works the same as the other ones, as the spots and the LEDs and the washers, but it doesn't create a bump executor. So now I just have and one part going to fill and back. I have an intensity I can use, and also I have a three-part effect, a standard effect in it. This for the ACLs, and I also can create that for dim two-part for the blinds over here. So that's a bit simpler, but it does the same. A little bit of Lua to get the label of the group, and there's also a one part on the page behind it. That's it for now. Next video, I'm going to show you how I'm using the effects in this basic show file, and I will show you in another video how I'm using a bit of remote demix inputs to change the bump, the colors and bump effects in my show.